Hey, right now I'm going to teach you the 6 public speaking tips to hook any audience. Hey, it's Ted McGrath, and I'm going to jump into the 6 public speaking tips to hook any audience. And right now I've got this awesome free gift on how to hook an audience. So let's jump in right now to the first thing that you need to know about public speaking. Whether you're on video, whether you're in front of an audience, you want to learn how to master the talk from the stage. So here it is. The first thing is all about attention. When you're walking out on a stage or you're in front of 10 people, you want to grab their attention. So if I walked out on stage and I was like, hey, I'm 22 years old. I'm the number 4 sales guy out of 120 in my office. I got the corner office, the 4-bedroom house. I'm driving the Benz. I'm the biggest baller in South Beach. And the night I crack 6 figures in income, I'm face down on the kitchen floor, overdosed from a bag of cocaine, 2 pops of ecstasy, and 15 vodka sodas. It's the greatest day of my life. So what are you thinking there? If I walked out and said something like that. Now that's actually a bit from my play that I do. I do a one-man play, so not only do I public speak, but I also tell a story about my life for 70 minutes and I play 12 different characters. And when I walk out on stage, I start off like that. So that's hooking attention. Why? Analyze what I just did. First of all, I put you in the present tense. So I'm like, I'm 22 years old. And you're looking at me, you're like, oh, maybe this guy's 30, maybe he's 40, maybe he's 20, I don't know. So I'm 22 years old, I'm putting you in the present tense. That's the first thing. The second thing is I'm going right into my success. So initially you're like, this guy's kind of cocky, he might be a little bit of an ass. I don't really know what to make of him, but then I hit you with, and I'm face down on the kitchen floor, I'm overdosed from a bag of cocaine, 2 pops of ecstasy, 15 vodka sodas. You're like, whoa, now I don't know what to think. And then I go, it's the greatest day of my life. Whoa, this is interesting. What's this talk gonna be all about? So if I hook you with that and I grab your attention right from the get-go, you're listening because you're wondering out of curiosity, who is this person who's about to get into their talk? Once I hook you with that, I can then hook you with the headline because you wanna know what this is about. You're like, okay, he's got my attention, what's this about? So then I'm gonna go, okay, so today I wanna talk to you about how to create a career that's super fulfilling so you don't waste your life and waste your dreams. Okay, I just made that up right now. I don't even talk on that subject. But from the story, I can then create any subject that I wanna talk about. I can walk out and say, hey, today I'm gonna talk to you about how to get off drugs and how to avoid addiction so you can live a fulfilling life, right? Hey, today I'm gonna talk to you about how to break 6 figures in income in your business and do something that you love. So my story opens up many, many avenues of what I want to speak on or what I want to talk to you about. So whatever I say after the story, it has to be a headline of what the topic of the talk is. So grab attention with something, maybe a story like I just did that has contrast, right? I'm talking about overdosing and then I'm going, it's the greatest day of my life. And somebody's like, what the hell is going on here? How is this the greatest day of his life? I would want to listen to the rest of the story, okay? So attention in public speaking comes from putting a little bit of contrast in there, a little bit of shock factor when you start off and when you come out on stage. Then you have to hit them with a headline, which grabs their attention also because now they're listening for how does this make sense. So if I'm talking about my career, and hey, I'm going to talk to you about how to create a fulfilling career today. Well, if I'm talking about that subject, it's going to make sense to you because I was just talking about how I made 6 figures and how I OD'd when I made 6 figures. So you're gonna go, okay, well, how do I create a fulfilling career so I don't die, right? You're thinking in your head, like, how do I create a fulfilling career so I actually do something that I love in my life and I don't waste my life? So I could have a headline that just says what it is and here's what I'm gonna talk about today. So that's how you grab attention from the start. The second thing that you wanna do is you wanna ask
questions.
So you might walk out to the audience and say, how many of you in the room would like to have a more fulfilling career? And people would raise their hands. You go, no, come on. How many people in the room right now? I mean, there's 150 people in this room right now. How many of you would like to have a more fulfilling career? Put your hands up. And people start to put their hands up. They're engaging, right? So that's a way to get people to interact. Then you could do the opposite of that, right? Rather than how many would like to have a fulfilling career, you might say, oh, great. And how many of you in the room right now kind of really don't like your job and you're looking for something different? So what you're doing right there in the questioning is 2 things. One, the first question, it evokes this opportunity, okay? It calls upon the opportunity of how many of you would like to have a more fulfilling career? People start to raise their hands, oh, great, yeah, I want a more fulfilling career. So you're getting people to agree to the topic right out of the gate. The second thing is the contrast of that is there might be a lot of people in the room who are thinking, my job sucks. I'm not even thinking about a fulfilling career. I'm just thinking about getting out of my job. How many of you kind of like on your way out of your job and you're like, yeah, I need to do something different, but I don't even know what the heck it is. I just want out of this thing. So now you've identified with two things, the problem and the opportunity. The opportunity is fulfilling career. The problem is I don't like my job. So just by asking questions and engaging them, you've established what every great talk must have, which is here's the problem, here's the opportunity, or here's the opportunity, here's the problem. Why? Because when you talk about the problem, people in the audience, some of them are stuck in the problem. They need to identify with what you're about to talk about. So if you jump to the solution or the opportunity too quickly, then people are like, wait, this guy doesn't get me. Like, I have a problem. He just jumped right over my problem and got into the content and started teaching. So you have to identify with your audience, and most of your audience is either focused on the future of the opportunity or they're focused on the problem. That's how you identify with them right out of the gate, which is asking great questions. And you could go on and on with those questions and go, yeah, great. So how many of you found a job that you loved, you know that you'd be making more money, you feel passionate every day, and you wake up in the morning and be like, this is a great life. You get people excited, right? It's another question. Okay, I'm making up this talk because I've done public speaking for so long. You can give me any topic and just talk on it. I just get up and I know the format. First thing is grab attention. Second thing is tell them what the topic is. That's kind of in the same breath, attention and topic. The second bullet point is really about asking questions to engage and get them to start thinking and identify with the audience. And then the third thing is really fully going into your story. I gave them a taste of my story right there, but if you fully go into your story, what actually happens? Well, when you fully go into your story, they actually go on the journey with you, and they actually experience the topic of the presentation before you ever get into the content of teaching. Now, I'm going to get into what content is in a second, but if you're ever going to speak in front of an audience, it's really good that you give them some content, some things they can take away and use in their life. So most public speakers teach something and they'll have bullet points of 3 to 5 things that they're going to teach. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's stick with story for a second, because story actually sets up the content. When the story's good, people are engaged and they're also open to receiving what you have to say. The other element of story that's really important is they don't know who you are. So a story builds credibility. So if you don't tell the story, they're wondering the whole way through the talk. They're like, who is this person talking to me? Why are they credible on this topic, and why should I even listen to them? So if I jumped in and I go, hey, you might be wondering, like, you know, I kind of started off a little strange about talking about ODing on the kitchen floor. Well, when I was 21 years old, here's the real story. I was actually 21 years old, and you know, I was working with this company for New York Life, and my boss looked at me and he's like, I believe that you can come out and crack 6 figures your first year in this business. And what did I know? I mean, I was in the insurance business. I didn't even know what I was doing there, but I wanted his approval. So I like put my head down. I was like, I'm going to crack 6 figures. And 12 months later, sure enough, I did. And then later that night, 4 o'clock in the morning, I find myself on the kitchen floor and I'm overdosed from a bag of cocaine, 2 pops of ecstasy, 15 vodka sodas. My soul's coming out of the top of my head. Now, the next morning I woke up and I was revived, but I was like sitting there with that question, like, you know, what am I going to do with my life? Now, I stopped doing drugs, but I continued to drink. And, you know, I went on, I started searching and searching because I realized money wasn't the answer, but I didn't know what the answer was. So I went out and I started searching, and I thought maybe like with this company, if I got into leadership and I became a partner and I got status, that would be the answer. So I put my head down for another 5, 6 years. And, you know, I woke up, you know, 6 years later, and I'm the top partner in the company. I'm the number 5 partner out of 500 partners in the entire company. And I get the news that day. My assistant walks in, she's like, here's the news. And I open it up and I see this, and I'm like sitting there with that question that most people have. Is this really all there is to my life? And so I resigned. And then I went on a search. I'm like, well, what do I really want to do? And so I moved out to California, you know, and I got the $1 million condo, the $100,000 car. I'm like, I'll become an entrepreneur that'll solve all my problems. And 2 years later, I started a couple of businesses that I'm not even passionate about. And then one day I'm sitting on my couch, I've got my house in foreclosure, and my face is my hands, my car's getting towed on my driveway, and I'm like, what the fuck am I gonna do with my life? And that was the day where I realized I wanted to help people. I wanted to make a difference in the world. So I got into coaching, I got into public speaking. And I went out and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna put on a seminar. And I put on my first seminar ever, and guess what happened? 20 people showed up in the room, 27 to be exact, and it was great, but I had nothing to sell. I had nothing to offer, so I was like, how do I make a living doing this? And then I geared up, I was like, well, maybe if I have some products and some things to sell from the stage, I could do really great. And sure enough, months later, I got 80-something people in the room, and I put on my first six-figure seminar ever, and my life changed. I realized, I want to speak, but then I took it further, and I realized, I have something to express in the world, so I created a play on my life story, because what greater form of public speaking than actually performing and expressing and acting and playing characters and all this stuff, and my life changed, it was amazing. So here's the deal. I gave you a condensed version of my story, but I told you a story. So as somebody who's listening, you're listening to public speaking right now, like you're watching this video because you have interest. I took you through the beginning of my journey. So anybody who's brand new, who's never done public speaking before, who's in a career like I was, who isn't fully fulfilled, who knows they have a bigger purpose, can look at it and actually go, oh my God, this guy started and he wasn't a speaker. And then he went through all this stuff and then he managed to still come out after overdosing and having all these problems. And he managed to have something to say to the world. So by the end of the story, the whole audience goes, I have something to say to the world, I could do this thing. Because I took them on a journey from the beginning to the end, and now I took them through my pit moments, and they realized, wow, this guy, he has flaws, but then he had this breakthrough, and then he went out and spoke, and he put on seminars, and he does this play, and now there's hope. So even the person at the lowest bottom of the barrel in the audience who has, like, their friend dragged them there, and they're like, they don't even know why they're at the seminar or listening in the audience, even that person has hope. The rest of the audience who's there, they're like jumping out of their chair, like, I want to do that thing too. Storytelling. Now, I haven't even gotten into the content yet, which is step number four. It's content, right? So number four is once you've told the story, they're set up for the content. Why? Because I dropped them from a place of vulnerability to where now they trust me. They're like, this guy's human, right? Then I brought them to a pinnacle and I showed them my results and they're like, wow, this guy's gotten results. So he's got credibility too. Vulnerability, credibility. So now when I go into my content, I go, so great, now I'm going to teach you the six things you must know about public speaking to hook any audience. You're listening. Because you're like, this guy has experience, he's done it. And he's also had challenges, and so have I. If you're in the audience, you're thinking, so have I. And like, if he did it, and he had challenges, and I could do it too. So before the content comes, you want the whole room receptive and open to going, I want to hear what this guy has to say. Wow, like I'm ready now for these six tips. Prior to that, they're not ready because if you didn't hook them with attention, you lost them in the beginning. If you didn't come out with questions to get agreement, they're not really agreeing to be there or even participate. If you didn't tell a good story, they're sitting there going like, what's this guy? Who is he? What's this even about? But once you do all that, then you get into the content. You teach them maybe three things, maybe six things. I don't typically go beyond, I go about three to five things, maybe sometimes seven. Seven's kind of a broad stroke. If I'm going to go deep dive, I go into three things. So if you're going to go broad stroke, you can do up to seven things. If you're going to go deep dive, do about two to three things. So you give them content and you teach them something. Something that would be useful, something that would be actionable, something that would be simple so they could understand it, you see? Once you've done the content, then what you want to do when you get to the end of the talk. Now, if you're selling something from the stage, this is super important. Whether you're not or you are, at the end of a talk, you want to speed up. Why? Because this is the end. It's like when you watch a movie, it's like, it's coming to like, you know, the pinnacle, right? Just like a talk, it's coming to the thing you want to speed up and inspire the audience. So if I were sitting there talking about public speaking, I was going, how many of you enjoyed the content today? You know, I would check again. How many of you enjoyed the content? Yes, awesome. Interact with them a little bit, get some connection going there. So how many of you could see yourself going out and doing this thing and actually going to book your first talk and get on a stage, even if you've never done it before? So now I'm asking questions that bring them into action. So I'm asking them questions that are action-based questions. They're seeing it and then I'm going, great. So I believe that you can go out and inspire the world today. In fact, I believe you have a message and you have something to say. And if you don't go speak to people, if you don't share your message, then one day we'll just wake up and we'll have a whole bunch of people running around unfulfilled in their life, not doing what they love. I know you have something inside of you. I know you have inspiration that's waiting to come out. I know you have a message to share with humanity. And if you do, it's time for you to stand up and stand for your own transformation so you can transform other people's lives. And if you're ready to do that, now's the time to get up out of your seat, to go to the back, buy my product. If you're not selling a product, you go, now's the time to get up out of your seat, to make a declaration, look at the person next to you and say, I'm going to go book a stage. I'm going to talk to an audience. I'm going to change somebody's life. And the first change starts with you changing your own life today and making a decision that this is what I want to do and sharing your voice. If you can't admit to yourself that you have something to say to the world, if you can't stand up and say, yes, I will speak to the world and I do have something to say, then you're never gonna do it if you can't do it in this room right now. So stand up, turn to the person next to you, tell them I have something to say, I have a voice for change, I'm gonna make a difference in the world. Boom, right? So you got them in action. You got them taking action on public speaking right there in the room. They're turning to the person next to them because most people have a dream, they have a secret thing, but they don't ever tell anybody what the dream is.
So if they don't do it in that moment, it just becomes an idea that lingers.
And then all of a sudden they walk around life, they're like, well, maybe I should tell somebody one day. And the longer they wait, they wake up 40 years later, they never do what they want to do. So if you get people into action, actually voicing it, it may be the first time they've ever told anybody that's what they want to do. And the funny thing is they're in a public speaking seminar watching, right? And they're there for public speaking, but they won't tell anybody they want to speak. Oh, I'm just doing the check it out thing. Yeah, I'm just checking it out. Like, I heard about doing this, and like, I thought public speaking, I've heard it might be effective, but really deep down inside, they're there because they know they want to public speak, but they don't want to tell anybody that because they're not confident. You see? So you got to get them to speed up, you got to get them to take an action, and then you go, great. So once they've done that, there's a little exercise in the room, then at the end you go, great. So how many of you believe that we can go out and change the world together. We can make a difference. It's time for us to unite our voices. It's time to bring messages of positive change to the world because the world needs it and the world's waiting. And if you don't get up and take action today, the world's gonna continue to wait and then we're gonna be in our demise. But if you stand up and you share your words today, just like you did, and you book that next stage, or you go out and you talk to that next person and you actually say something that matters in the world with a message, you're gonna change people's lives. So we're gonna do this together. This is a movement of people who have a voice for change. If you're in for the voice for change, I want you to stand up right now. I want you to raise your hand. I want you to make the declaration right now. And I want you to leave this room totally determined to go out and change the world. Let me know right now, are you in this with me? And they're like, yes, great. Let's go out and make a difference, change the world. I'll see you soon, bye. Right? So you do that and you bring the we together and you just, boom, you lift the audience and you end on a high note and people are ready to get into action and they're excited and they've already taken action in the room. So the chances of them going out and taking some action after that, for most of them, it's pretty good. For some of them, they won't. But for many of them, they will if you give them a baby action step to do. So that's how I would do it. Here's the 6 points again. Number one, grab their attention, right? Number two, ask them some questions to get agreement. Number three, tell a story to build vulnerability and credibility and trust with the audience. Number four, give them some content, teach them something. Number five, speed, right? Speed it up, right? And number six, we bring it together, unite the room at the end so everybody feels bonded and boom, put them into action. So that's how you do it. If you like this, I want you to go ahead right now and grab the gift because this gift right now on how to hook an audience is powerful. It goes way more in depth into the teachings that I just shared with you. And it really helps you get on the path to mastering speaking in front of an audience. So grab the gift right now. Also, I got many other great videos coming out. So subscribe to my channel if you want to get more free videos like this. And leave your comments down below because I'd like to answer your questions. Because I know when you're going out to public speak, you probably have some questions. You might have some nerves. You might have some apprehension. But ask your questions down below. And if you like this video and it gave you some value today, go ahead and actually like it down below. It would really help me and serve me. So let's go out and make a difference in the world together, sharing our voices, and I hope this serves you. I'll see you soon.